Let's take a look at an overview of Science DMZ Security. The goal for Science DMZ Security is, of course, to defend the assets in the Science DMZ. The way we're going to do that is we're going to disentangle the security policy and policy enforcement mechanisms used to defend data-intensive science applications from the security policy and policy enforcement mechanisms used to defend enterprise or business systems. The rationale for this is that the two traffic profiles are actually quite different. In the Science DMZ, we have data transfer applications that need to move at high speed with small number of flows and very high per flow data rate. In an enterprise environment, we have a very large number of data flows, each of which is pretty low performance, actually. And we have a wide variety of applications running with a pretty significant attack surface and threat profile. Whereas in the Science DMZ, the data transfer applications, all they do is exchange credentials over an encrypted channel, open up a couple of data sockets, write a few terabytes to disk, and close. That traffic profile is much simpler from a network security perspective, and so by disentangling that from the enterprise traffic, it allows us to do some optimizations for performance reasons. So if we look at the core information security principles of confidentiality, availability, and integrity, in the Science DMZ for data-intensive science, we've added a fourth requirement, which is performance. We can call it PICA if we want to pronounce it. We can say CIAP if we want to pronounce a bunch of letters, but it doesn't really matter all that much how we describe it. The key point here is we have a fourth requirement, performance. If the performance is compromised, the science mission fails. So we have to figure out a way to secure our systems while maintaining the performance that's required to support the science workflows. If we look at the way the Science DMZ is constructed, the Science DMZ is outside the enterprise firewall from a network perimeter design perspective. That's deliberate. The data packets going from the wide area network into the data transfer node do not traverse the data plane of the firewall. That doesn't mean they don't go through packet filters, but they don't go through the data plane of a firewall. And that's specifically because the data plane of a firewall is engineered to provide a wide variety of additional security services that often come with a performance penalty. So what are those security services? Firewalls are incredibly sophisticated in an enterprise environment. They do protocol analysis, they do deep packet inspection, they're user aware, they've got integrated VPNs, they've got a whole bunch of stuff that's completely irrelevant for the workflow of a data transfer node in a Science DMZ. And so if all we need to do is move 5 terabytes of data from one file system to another file system, and we're going to use a simple tool to do it, we can optimize the way in which we do the security for the Science DMZ to accommodate that. Now, if we were going to do this through a firewall, we'd have to ask the firewall administrator to open up the data transfer application to allow it through the firewall. What would the firewall administrator ask for? They would not ask for what tool we were using so they could implement a sophisticated protocol analyzer to deeply understand exactly what was going on inside the data transfer application. Instead, all they're going to do is ask you for the address and ask you for the port. If all we're going to do is filter by address and port, we can write an access list to do exactly that same thing. And the access list functionality is already built into the Science DMZ switch router you've already bought. You don't have to buy a firewall in order to do that. And in fact, the access list is not going to cause a performance impact to traffic that's permitted by policy. So that's actually a really key point. Traffic permitted by policy should not experience performance impact as a result of the policy being applied. So does this mean that we ignore security? Absolutely not. We do packet filtering, in some cases very aggressive packet filtering, in the Science DMZ. But we do Science DMZ security in a way that does not compromise the performance of the science mission for which the Science DMZ assets were deployed.